Let us first consider a simpler sentence. So consider the sentence, Ashok made pancakes for David with a griddle. I'm sure you understood the meaning of this sentence almost immediately. But what did you understand? What is the meaning of meaning? We can do several different kinds of analysis on this sentence. We can do lexical analysis, which will categorize each of these words into different lexical categories. For example, Ashok is a noun, made is a verb, pancakes is a noun, and so on. We can do syntactic analysis in terms of the structure of this particular sentence. So we might say Ashok is a noun phrase, made pancakes for David with a griddle is a verb phrase, and this particular verb phrase itself has subphrases in it. Or we can do semantic analysis on this and say that Ashok was the agent, made was the action, pancakes were the object that got made, David was the beneficiary, and griddle was the instrument. The knowledge-based AI approach to understanding stories like this, semantic analysis is at the forefront. Syntactic analysis and lexical analysis will serve semantic analysis. So here are some of the semantic categories in terms of which we can classify the different words in the sentence. So Ashok is an agent, made is an action, a verb in a lexical sense, pancakes are the thematic object, the things that are getting made, and so on. The frame for representing understanding of this sentence has the verb or the action make, the agent Ashok, and so on, just like we just discussed. This then is the meaning of meaning. This is what the AI agent understands when it understands the meaning of this sentence. This is perhaps also what you understand when you understand the meaning of this sentence. How do we know that you understood the meaning of this sentence? Well, we know that because I can ask you some questions and you can draw the right kind of inferences from it. So for example, given this sentence, I can ask you, well, who ate the pancakes? And you might be able to say, well, David ate the pancakes because Ashok made the pancakes for David. Notice that this information about who ate the pancakes was not present in this particular sentence. This is an inference you're drawing. This is very similar to what we had encountered earlier when we had sentences like Ashok ate a frog. At that time, too, we had asked questions like, well, was Ashok happy at the end? And the frame had some default values which said Ashok was probably happy. Or was the frog dead at the end? And the frame for eating had some default value which said that the frog was dead at the end. So according to this theory, the meaning lies in the inferences we can draw from it. You understand the meaning of this if you can draw the right inferences. You do not understand the meaning of this if you cannot draw the right inferences or if you can draw only the wrong inferences. This frame representation of the meaning of this particular sentence allows you to draw the right inferences. Given the action make here, the thematic role pertains to the relationship of various words in the sentence to this particular action of making. Ashok is the agent, David is the beneficiary, and so on. So far, we have described the meaning of this sentence and how we can capture that meaning in this frame. We have not yet described the process by which this knowledge is extracted out of that sentence. The extraction of the meaning of this sentence is exactly the topic that we will discuss next.